I'm Maureen and welcome to my kitchen. Today we've got a kitchen basic. I'm going to show you how to do a basic flatbread dough, and in another video I'm going to use that dough to make a dinner flatbread that we're going to enjoy for supper tonight. So let's go see how we make basic flatbread. I am just going to tell you what's going in the bowl as I make the recipe. So what goes in the bowl first is water. This is warm water between 105 and 110 degrees, and that is a cup and a half tablespoon of instant yeast, tablespoon of sugar, 2 tablespoons of olive oil, and then we're going to put 3.5 to 4 cups of all-purpose flour. And this is how I measure. You can either do the fluff and scoop method, you can do the scoop and sweep method, or you can do this, which is me pouring it in here. That was 3, and almost maybe a little bit over a half. We'll have this, and I have a tablespoon of salt. We're also going to need some semolina flour for later, for when we roll this out. This is what we'll put on the bottom, so that it has a nice crumb. You can also use cornmeal. All right, with our dough hook, we're gonna go ahead and mix this, and then we're gonna knead it for 5 minutes once it comes together. Okay, our dough has finished kneading. It kneaded for 5 minutes.
It needed to knead.
All right, I'm just going to take it out of the bowl here with my dough scraper, and I'm going to show it. It's not completely sticky, but when you feel it's going to have a little bit of tack to it, and that's what you want. You don't want it to be totally smooth like a bread dough. This is a flatbread, and it's going to be a little on the chewy side, so that's what you want. You want it to be just a little bit tacky in a good way. Not like your neighbor with the flat pants. Okay. I'm just going to let this hang out for about 30 minutes. This is not an hour-long rise. This is just about a 30-minute rise. And then we'll be back and we'll show you what happens next. Okay, it has been just over 30 minutes. And now what we're going to do is we're going to gently deflate the dough. Don't punch it. It didn't do anything to you. I always say that. You got to be nice to your dough. Okay. And then what you can do is you can choose to use this however you like. You can divide this up into individual flatbreads. You can make one massive flatbread, which is what I'm going to use it for. Or you can divide it in however many that you like. You know, 1, 2, 6, it just depends. And you're going to bake this off in an oven that's preheated at 450 degrees for about 15 minutes. You can add all kinds of toppings to it. You can just put olive oil and herbs on it. You can break it up, rip it apart, and use it like a flatbread in like fattoush salad or something like that. It's delicious and it's beautiful. And I'll put a picture at the end of this video to show you what I'm going to do with it, because I'm going to do a super cheesy chicken flatbread out of this, and I'm going to do that in a separate video, and you'll be able to see that once I get it uploaded. I'll make sure and link it below. So that is how you make beautiful flatbread dough that you can use for just about anything. This is great for topping. You can put lots of different things on this. Think like goat cheese and pears and honey, or olives and tomatoes, or cooked sweet potatoes and sage, or your leftover Thai peanut pad Thai. You can toss on the top with a little more sauce and pop it in the oven, and it's delicious for supper. So, basic flatbread dough. I hope you try it. I hope you love it. And until next time, I'll see ya. To enjoy. Look at that. Look at that. And I'm gonna show you the bottom. I have to hold these toppings on. Look how beautiful that is. For joining me in my kitchen today. I hope you liked what you watched today, and I hope that you try it, and I hope that you love it. If you like what you saw, please consider hitting the thumbs up button and giving me a positive rating. And also, make sure that you hit the subscribe button if you're already not a subscriber, so that you don't miss out on any of the fun we have here in our kitchen every single day. I hope that you enjoyed it. I'm really glad that you're here. Thank you for stopping by. Don't forget to come by tomorrow. Until next time, happy eating!